is every time you sit down, you're frozen to let anything out.
I have three layers. Amazing.
Are you wearing adult diapers?
Yes, I just saw that on the train. I was reading the article.
She won't take on a boy.
You're not cold?
Did your mom say don't go out of the house in shorts when it's less than 10 degrees
now? Are you related?
No.
What would you do if your kid went out like that today?
My kid wouldn't go out like that.
I strike for 10 months, especially when I take away all our benefits, our 401k, everything else, and this gentleman who's about to be inaugurated has turned his back on us. Promises, 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 and has done nothing about it for 10 months. Him and the government. I don't want to blame just him.
Okay,
and Tom Rutledge, the $98 million CEO, he's starving out 1,800 families for 10 months. And nobody talks about it. It's nowhere to be found on the media.
Okay, raise your hand if you're cold. So, what do you expect for the next 4 years of from the administration? Nothing? Nothing.
What?
Nothing.
I hear the weather's going to get better. It's going to become warmer. That's what I heard.
So much better.
U.S. Senator from Vermont, Bernie Sanders, and his wife, Jane Sanders. New York State Lieutenant Governor, Kathy Hochul. New York State Comptroller, Tom DiNapoli, U.S. Congressman Jerry Nadler, Brooklyn Borough President.
Please welcome Comptroller Scott M. Stringer and retired clerk of the City of New York, Carlos Cuevas.
Claims that made the entire world aware of what women have known since we set foot in the workplace. And as we begin a new day in our city, we carry the same optimism, that same grit, and that same passion that makes New York, New York. Let's seize this opportunity together and let us continue to march on.
And the issues go on and on and on. Criminal justice, bringing the police into the communities. Immigration reform, and telling the 800,000 young people today who are terrified about losing their legal status and being subjected to deportation that in this city, at least, they are safe. And the bottom line is that what Mayor de Blasio and his administration understand is that in this country, in the home of Ellis Island, our job is to bring people together with love and compassion.
The theme of our campaign just passed was simple and clear.
It is a reminder that the true owners of this beloved place are not the big landlords and developers. Not the titans of Wall Street and the 1%. With a simple call to arms, we have a responsibility, every one of us, to ensure that New York remains a beacon to our nation and to the world.
What has this meant to you to be here for another beautiful inauguration?
Well, I continue to believe in our city. And I believe in its current leadership, and I'm delighted to be here.
Right. Is this the coldest it has ever been?
Well, I suppose it is. It was cold on September 1st, 1990, when I was inaugurated, but not this cold.